So I got a fish recently. Actually, I got a bunch of fish recently. But one of the fish that I got was something that I put in the Indian mudskipper tank. I wanted to have a fish that was not too big, not too small, that could live in brackish water, which is a mixture of salt water and fresh water, and kind of live peacefully with my Indian mudskippers, which are kind of small. They're not super aggressive. So I wanted to find a fish that would be perfect for that. If you guys are following my channel, you know that I do have two brackish tanks set up with mudskippers, one with African mudskippers, the other with Indian mudskippers. The Africans are much larger, a little bit more aggressive, well, a lot more aggressive, and they have much larger appetites. I used to want to put bumblebee gobies in that tank when I realized that the bumblebee gobies were going to be too small, that they wouldn't work with the Africans. I had to get something else, so I ended up getting my puffer. But now that I do have the Indian mudskipper tank, I got the bumblebee gobies. So these guys are great. They're super peaceful. You know, they do very well in brackish water. They don't need a huge amount of water area because they are a very small fish. This is a goby tank. They're both gobies. Indian mudskippers are from the goby family, as are obviously the bumblebee gobies. So they cohabitate very well, same water conditions, and they actually eat the same food. As far as feeding, I feed them a mixture of different types of dry food or freeze-dried food, and sometimes frozen foods as well. So they get freeze-dried bloodworms, frozen brine shrimp, freeze-dried mysis shrimp. Sometimes they'll eat like the little fruit flies, the live fruit flies, if some happen to hop into the water. And they also eat flake food, so it's very easy to feed them. They've been very, very active in the tank, and I'm just really, really enjoying these guys. So a few things to kind of know about the bumblebee gobies is they do stay small. They're a very peaceful fish. They can be territorial, so you don't want to you know, put other fish in there that are gonna try to occupy their same area. They do spend a lot of time not really swimming around. They don't swim back and forth in the water so much. They kind of spend a lot of their time kind of resting at the bottom, resting on rocks, etc. So they can be a little bit territorial of their area, but overall they are a pretty peaceful fish. So it's really ideal to have a setup with various types of hiding places for them, whether it be, you know, some type of plant that can tolerate brackish water. I happen to use plastic plants in my brackish water just because I haven't had a lot of success outside of, well, inside the water. Outside of the water, I do have some options. But other than that, they do need to have, you know, lots of hiding places. They do well in community settings. They do well in groups. So I actually have 8 of them in this tank, and they're doing very well. Getting along just fine. The tank is large enough to where they can kind of hide and get their own area. The tank is 36 inches long, I believe. So they do kind of have the ability to, you know, swim and hide and go to other places without having someone right in their face. I haven't had them for very long. I am hoping to maybe get them to spawn in the future. I currently am keeping them in brackish water. Some of the research that I've done has told me that if you add fresh water to the system, it kind of triggers the spawning behavior. So that might be something that I might try in the future, you know, during some water changes, maybe add more fresh water than brackish water, just to see if I can kind of trigger some of that behavior. And I'll probably do that sometime later this summer. They are a predatory fish, so you know, if you do feed live foods, they will go after that food. And that can be interesting to watch as well. And a couple other things, their pH requirements are not too specific. They can handle anything from 7 to the mid 8s, and the temperature anywhere between 75 to 82 degrees. So anyway, that's a little bit about the bumblebee goby. Again, something that I wanted to get, wasn't able to get them because of the other tank mates, the African mudskippers, but I've loved these guys. I've had them for a while now. Very enjoyable, kind of, even though they're a very small fish, they do have a lot of personality, so I really am enjoying that. Sometimes I'll just sit in front of the tank and just kind of watch them swim around and, you know, interact with one another and feed, and it's just a lot of fun. So hopefully you guys enjoy this short little video, and definitely if you guys have any comments about bumblebees, if you kept them before or if you plan on keeping them, please comment down below. I try to read and answer almost everyone's questions as much as possible, or other people will answer as well. So anyway, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you like it. Thanks for watching. We'll catch you on the next one.